Hi children, welcome back to you. Okay, in this video we are going to learn about the first lesson of your EVS, that is the food, our basic need. Of course we have done this one in the online classes, but then also those who have not attended in the online class, for them it will be helpful, and even who have attended, for them it will be just like a revision part. First lesson is the food, our basic need. Then because to live, to survive this life, we need food, isn't it? Without food, it's not possible for our body to perform any activity. Not only the human being, even other animals also, we need food to perform other various activities, and even be to be energetic and to be active, to grow, to maintain our health, we need food, isn't it? Then what is this food? Food means there are so many varieties. They will come in front of our eyes, that some of them will be like favorite, and some of them will be like protein oriented, some of them will be energy oriented, and our mother, grandmother, they will suggest us to eat this one, it will be good for your health, and eat this one, this will be good for your health. So like this they will suggest. So variety of food we will eat every day, and how they are variety, different, even they are different in the taste also, because each food is going to give us the different taste. Like this, components of food also we will learn in this chapter, and even food means the eating items will be there in a group, and they those items will give us the different nutrients. This is called as the food. Nutrients, you can understand that energies and different nutrient means different type of energy, different type of vitamins, minerals, these all we are going to get. Now this is what the food. Again we will learn in the next, that is what is balanced food and how we should eat the food, what material we should eat the food, we will learn in the next part. Then here comes, as I told you, the different food gives us the different taste, and even its color, looking, everything will be different. Then we have many components of the food. Components of the food means parts of the food, we have different varieties in that. Then for example, as I told you, what we eat in the morning will be different from what we eat in the afternoon, that is lunch, the breakfast, lunch, dinner, all three will be varieties. They will be different in the taste, they will be different in the how they are going to give us the energy, like this they are different. Then how this differentiate has come, how this different taste has come, and how these are going to be differentiate, how these are going to be beneficial for our health. So depending upon this, we have divided the food item into different parts. Those are called as the components of the food. For example, carbohydrates, proteins, and fats, and minerals, and the vitamins. So like this we have divided the food item, whatever we eat in the food, those all have divided into different parts. First of all, the carbohydrate means what, children? See, now we eat every day, normal food will be chapati, roti, rice, sambar, bhaji. Okay, this all we will eat. Especially every day, we will never prefer every day the special food and all. So this simple and basic food will give us lot of energy. Then energy giving food like chapati, roti, rice, and like grains and cereals. So like this, usually these all are going to give us the energy. For example, who is going to do lot of physical work, that may be the farmers, that may be the labor, that may be the sportsman, they need lot of energy. So they need to eat the food, or again and again they need to eat the food which give them the energy. Those are called as the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are mainly called as energy giving food. Which are the carbohydrates we use in our eating food like roti, jowar, wheat, and rice, and bhajis, and even like sambar, whatever we eat, these all will come under the, even grain cereals, these all will come under the energy giving food. These all are going to give us the carbohydrate. By eating carbohydrate food, we get lot of energy. Okay, and then what about the proteins? See here, if we drink a lot of milk, and even if we use the grains, cereals, grams, variety of grams, all type of grams, we get the protein. Then what is this protein? Protein is going to give us or maintain our health, and even it is going to build our body. Because of this, we call protein as a body building food. Proteins are body building food, because proteins, these all fresh vegetables and especially grains, okay, grains, almonds, paneer, milk, egg, okay, and even the meat. Meat means it will be there, different type of meats will be there. So these all are going to cereals, grains, grams, like dal and all we will eat, no, and even this grains, bhaji we will eat, no, like this. If we use, simply if we use at least once or at least thrice or twice or thrice in a 1 week food schedule, if we use one time bhaji or two time bhaji, we are going to get lot of proteins to our body. Even by drinking milk, by eating egg, that may be boiled, that may be fried, whatever it is, and paneer, and like almonds and this dry fruits, if we eat these all in our meal in a simple manner or in a simple step, we are going to get lot of protein. So these proteins are going to help to maintain our body growth. If our body growth is normal, then it should be understood that we have good protein for our health. And the growth of hair, growth of the nails, and our skin, maintenance of our skin. And if suppose we have some wounds, some scratches or something happened to our body, of course we something will happen to our body. There may be a tearing, there may be a cutting. Do we have ever thought how do the wound is going to heal, or how do the cuts of our bodies are going to heal? These are going to heal only because of the protein. So if we eat lot of protein in our food, so those are going to help us to build our body again. So then the carbohydrates are energy giving food, and proteins are the body building food. Okay, about the fat and oils and vitamins and minerals, we will learn in the next video, children. I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed in this video. And after seeing this video, you can go and read the textbook once again. You will get the clear picture. Okay, so let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.